Okay, my name is Frans Kopers. I live in Belgium, in Ghent. I was a medical student when I met Mark van Koomberg, Dr. Mark van Koomberg. You heard about him, maybe? And he just came back from Boston, where he studied with Mitchell and Aveline and all the people there. And that was in the 70s. And he was giving lectures, so I started going to his lectures because I met him in a health food restaurant and we started talking. And he was the first person who could explain me macrobiotics in a logical way, not in a kind of floating way, let's say. So I started going to his lectures and I got so interested, I dropped my studies and I started working to go to Boston. So I went there in 72 and 74, 2 times 6 months. I came back, started a health food restaurant, which I did for 7 years. I sold it. After 7 years, it was quite successful. We had about 300 people every day. And with that money, I went to Japan for 8 months to study macrobiotics, or shokuyo, as they call it, to train Aikido, which I was doing also, and to study shiatsu at the Yokai. With Kimura Sensei. Masunaga, the founder of the Yokai, was dead, died already. So I studied with one of his students. Then I came back, I started a practice, started a school, and a Belgian Shiatsu Federation. In the beginning, it was Shizuko Yamamoto. You know her? Do you know her?
Yes.
Shizuko
sure.
Yamamoto.
Yes,
she was the shiatsu teacher in Boston, and she asked me to start a branch of the International Macrobiotic Shiatsu Society, which I did. Then we wanted to get a member of the European Shiatsu Federation, so we had to change the name and drop macrobiotics because we had to be open to all shiatsu styles. So I've been president and secretary of all kinds of organizations. And in 2012, I stopped my school and I kind of retired of all my official functions because at the same time, I was lobbying on Belgian and European level for natural health and natural medicine. So not only for shiatsu, not only for macrobiotics. And like 7, 8 years ago, I stopped all that. I officially retired. But still went on practicing. So I'm still practicing almost every day, practicing shiatsu and seiki. In 1992, after I came back from Japan in 1985, I met a Japanese person in Brussels who was doing some kind of, I could call it energetic shiatsu based on energy. It's very, very simple, very simplified. In shiatsu, you have two ways. Getting more and more mental, complicated Chinese theories and becoming more simple. And the Seiki practice is like a way that simplifies things as much as possible. In such a way that you might call it in the Chinese way, Wei Wu Wei, doing by not doing. But my teacher, Kishi Sensei, which you can see here, he always said, nothing to do. Nothing to do. So his name is Kishi, and if I ever write my memoirs, it will be from Kushi to Kishi. From Kushi to Kishi. So Kishi was my first Japanese sensei, and Kishi will be my last. He died a couple of years ago, and he had to cancel his workshop I was organizing for him, and he called me from Germany, and he asked me, please continue my work. So that's what I did. And I teach a little bit all over the world now, mainly in shiatsu practice. But it's also a way for me to reintroduce macrobiotics in all my classes. I wrote 2 books about Seiki. This is one of them, Seiki Practice. And there's a couple of pages I also talk about macrobiotics, because for me it's all the same, the principles, the background, the goals, they are all the same for me. So I do not make distinction between any practice. And as I'm still working, I'm officially retired, but as we say here, I will die with my boots on.
Yeah.
So generally, I do not teach anymore in the traditional way, like I have a topic and I work the topic out and I explain theories, because the problem in Seiki is that the theory is very limited. It's about feeling, it's about touching, it's about developing. I always say in Seiki, the Seiki way is, it's a discovery, not of something new, but something you know, but you forgot about, a way to touch. Second, it's development. It's practice and development. Discovery, practice and development. And the funny thing is that at some point, a student asked Kishi-sensei, how many times you have to come to a Seiki workshop to be able to practice? And he said, one time is enough. So it's extremely simple, but as far as I'm concerned, one of the most genuine and spiritual hands-on work that I've ever met. So that's a little bit what I'm doing now. But at the same time, you have the energy, you have energy and matter, and macrobiotics, as Micho says in one of his books, The Origin and the Destiny of Man, he says that health is just the beginning. People who think, well, I restored my health, so I understand macrobiotics, I think he calls them fools. So it's an ongoing process, and I think the process goes on all your life. And at the same time, I have no specific goals anymore in my life. I just go my way. And as they say in Zen, I can never lose my way because I have no goal. So, as they say sometimes, I go with the flow. I just manage to, and I'm enjoying my life pretty much. So that's what I'm doing. And if people want, of course, I think most of people know Shiatsu. I remember when I was in Boston the first time, that was in 1972. One of the first classes, of the main classes that were given there was Shiatsu. I don't know if that is still the case in Shiatsu centers or if people still combining Shiatsu and macrobiotics. But for me, it's like left and right hand. If you advantage of Seiki, and I must say that macrobiotics, you had Lima factory here and the family Gevaert, and Osawa has been here, and Lima Osawa has been to my restaurant. I mean, Ghent used to be a very popular place in macrobiotics, and I remember that Kishi once said that Belgium would be the first country where all people would be macrobiotic. And I must say, with all respect for Micho, that he was wrong. It did not happen. But at the same time, it's not very popular anymore, macrobiotics here in Ghent or in Belgium. But for me, like if you do shiatsu, people feel immediately some effect. With food, sometimes it takes weeks or months before they start to get any better. So in shiatsu, I can use it as kind of an introduction, you know, and you gain credibility because so many people are talking about food. You have so many ways, so many approaches, and my approach is just to kind of, well, massage them a little bit so it enters better. Okay, anyway, that's about it. It's very difficult, of course, to show what actually Seiki is. But maybe if people have questions, I can go and surf on that.
Okay, let's call for questions. See if there's enough material that people already have ideas and interests. You might want Franz to speak a little bit more just to give us some food for thought, some direction.
Well, it's very difficult. Seiki is easy to do, but difficult to explain. Well, what is the goal? The goal, Kishi said always, it's my goal is to make people a little bit more happy. He avoided all medical terminology. So making people more happy for him automatically leads to better health. But health is a complex, it's something simple and complex at the same time. Actually, if in a treatment, in a Seiki treatment, which you have heard about Reido? Everybody heard about Reiki? Reiki, everybody, Usui Sensei, but it's very, you have secrets, you have all kind of keys and all kind of special recommendations and things you have to do. In Seiki, that does not exist. I always say that the secret of Seiki is that there is no secret. It's something you have to discover. There's no secret. The theory of Seiki you can put on one page. And the central thing of Seiki is Gyoki. And Gyoki means that you breathe through your hands. You breathe through your hands and you imagine that you breathe, through your hands and you develop and then you start working. Yeah, maybe we sit if people want to practice, I did it in Hong Kong once with Skype, with Hong Kong and people could feel. So you put your hands in the prayer position. It's called the Gassho position, but that means in front of your heart and 45 degrees, not up like this. That's the Holy Mary, like this, relaxed, shoulders relaxed. And you you may close your eyes and you imagine that you breathe in through your fingertips and you breathe out to your palms. You're sitting up straight, your shoulders relaxed. You breathe in through the nose and you breathe out through your mouth. Your hands are not glued to each other. Just relax. Only the fingertips and the borders of your hands touch. So you have an empty space between your hands. And maybe at some point you will feel some warmth, a little bit sweaty, a little bit transpiration, or some tingling. And then you open your hands and you try to keep this interaction between left and right. You might feel some kind of energy in between it. And you can experiment with it. That means that you change the position of your hands and your attention goes completely to the space between your hands and you observe what you feel. And if you're lucky, then you feel that there's some kind of an energetic ball between your hands. And this ball changes the size all the time in a way that he is pushing you around now. And sometimes the ball gets so big that he is filling the room in front of you and push you a little bit to the back and then becomes small again. And both hands, or yin and yang, they work together. Life is the interaction between yin and yang. Left hand, more yin, right hand, more yang. Left hand, the unconscious hand, nigate, as Kishi told it. Right hand, the more active, conscious hand, and they work together. And then slowly we go back, and the hands get closer, and slowly we come back to the prayer position. And we observe what we feel. Still breathing in through the nose, breathing out through the mouth. And now, in this is kind of meditation, you might say, but in Seiki, we are not sitting still. That means when you breathe in, you bend a little bit backwards, lift the hands a little bit. When you breathe out, you bend a little bit to the front and your hands lower a little bit. Life is movement, as Kushi said. So in Seiki, we're never sitting still, always moving, movement. And then to stop the exercise, we blow in between the hands, and it's finished. So this exercise is what we call Gassho Gyoki. And Gassho is the prayer position. And Gyoki is like ki exercise. Gassho Gyoki. Gassho Gyoki. And this is the basic of Seiki treatment. Another point which might be interesting to know is that in Seiki we have no attention. So we have no goal. We do not want to cure somebody. Michio always talked about trust in the order of the universe. That's exactly the attitude when you treat somebody with Seiki. So there's no structure or very little structure. Kata is a form. Kishi always said form is okay in the beginning, but form should lead to no form. And the attitude is not too serious, not sending energy, not expecting anything, just touch and let the energy guide you. So it's kind of spontaneous treatment. And very interesting part of it, I've been doing pure shiatsu for decades and before I knew Seiki, and I must say I was kind of getting tired. It was exhausting. And in Seiki, it's both people profit from it. Kishi Sensei always said, it's not always sure who is treating who. Only one thing is sure, he said. I received the money. So he was very practical at the same time. But I'm just enjoying this so much that with this whole confinement here, with this COVID and stuff like that, I really missed it. I missed it. Of course, I was treating my wife, but I mean, treating my clients, for me, it's just a joy. It's not work. It's not work. And people are happy, so. But anyway, there also may be another thing that might be interesting to hear is that in Seiki treatment, sometimes in one treatment, people get much better, like almost miracle. But the first thing of the first stage of the effect of Seiki is deep relaxation. That's fundamental. And people go into a state of, I dare to call it, I'm very careful with these very spiritual words, but they get into a state of no ego. They just let go. And the second, then if that goes well, the second stage is that people get into, how would I say, a phase of higher sensitivity. At that point, their problems, their aches, their tensions come up to the surface. And for some people, it's a very difficult moment. That's why I used to say that the psyche is all also a confrontation with your own demons a little bit. Because things come to the surface and to your consciousness. Also, unconscious stuff comes up from a long time before, comes to your consciousness. But then when it comes to the surface, after that you have elimination. And it starts to go away. It's like, how would I say, evaporating. And people forget about things, a better part of problems, and it can go a long, long way back. I had it was during a workshop, a man who had kidney problems. And it was the first shiatsu class, a couple of classes, and then seiki. And with the shiatsu classes, he was better for, let's say, 50%. And then during the seiki, he had what we call a katsugen. So people start to move spontaneously. And he was kind of crawling in the air. He was treated by another student and he came to me and he said, well, this was not funny. I revived a suicide attempt I did 15 years ago. And if that comes back, I'm just leaving here. I said, okay, come on the mat, I will treat you. So I treated him. And then at some point he started laughing. I started talking all kinds of stories in his life, but he was laughing, Homeric, I call it Homeric laughing. And after that, his kidney problem was gone. So I think if Seiki is doing something, it's to release or to, it's not making balance in a person. It's making the energy flow again. And then the body itself is balancing. We are not balancing anything. We're just kind of the catalyst, you know, catalyst making things go and then troubles and tensions go away. I can tell you like all afternoon about all kind of stuff like this that which happened during classes and so on. Maybe just the last one, a more physical one. There was a lady in one of my classes and she was a piano player. So, but she had a ski accident. She broke her wrist. And she could not, after the plaster was gone, she could not move her hand anymore this way. So she could not play the piano anymore. So during the treatment, her arm spontaneously started like shaking. And then it calmed down. And after that, she could play again. For 10 years, her hand was kind of fixed. And suddenly, so it's almost miraculous. I'm not telling you stories. This really happened. This really happened. It's not always like that. But I just had a whole week course in Germany and people are so happy after this. It's kind of liberating. It's liberating. And I'm sure all during this this class also we eat macrobiotic food. We meditate, we do also Qigong and all kind of exercises. And this is really great. And I'd like to introduce that as much as I can because you never know when you die. But I'd like to share this with people because it's so simple. It's so simple. People after one class already, they can practice. So you don't have to, like in Shiatsu, you have trainings from going from 500 to 2000 hours. In Seiki, the touch is always very, very soft, especially in the beginning. Kishi always said, you have to treat people like if it were babies. So it's a very soft touch. Even at some point when you touch the hara, the belly, Kishi said, it's like a butterfly landing on a flower. Always soft like that. So it's very feminine after all. It's a very soft way, like a mother treating her baby. Like in Shiatsu, Namikoshi, you heard about Namikoshi? No, Namikoshi is one of the big Shiatsu schools in Japan, the Shiatsu College it's called. And he had the saying, Shiatsu no kokoro, haha no kokoro. That means The heart of shiatsu is the heart of a mother. And nowadays, most shiatsu styles is the heart of a father. They are strong and hard and kind of punishing. So if Seiki is anything, it's really this heart of the mother, like the soft touch, gentle touch, and then people open up and things start to move and they get better, really. And if they change their food, the both together, then, well, I mean, I'm sure that you can live like Lima Osawa for 100 years. So that's a little bit, yeah. So you have first relaxation, I forgot something. You have first relaxation, then you have higher sensitivity, then you have elimination. And when all that, these phases are finished, then you have vacation. You are on holidays, Kishi says. You're on holidays. And I just read this little booklet, maybe you know it, from Micho, Macrobiotics, An Invitation to Health and Happiness. And he says too, you know what, the final goal of macrobiotics is happiness. So for me, Seiki and macrobiotics is the same. It's just another way, another approach. But they are very complementary, because if people keep eating meat and sugar and whatever and cheese, then they'll never profit from Seiki as much as if you're eating healthy, of course. But I think at the same time that for many people who have psychological and emotional trauma in their lives, that with macrobiotics, it does not easily come out. So I think some hands-on work, in my experience at least, is quite important, quite important. So that's the whole theory of Seiki in one page. That's all you have to know. The rest is practice.
So, of course, the first question is, when can you come to Israel? We'll do a workshop.
Well, we can by email, send me an email. We can, because I have conditions that are very, how would I say, supple, but we can discuss that by email. And I'd love to come to Israel. I'd love to come to Israel. You know, in the beginning of my shiatsu practice, I went to Antwerp 2 days in the week to treat Jewish people there, and I loved them. We had very good contact. They were so lovely, these people. I, at some point, I was too busy in Ghent, and I gave this business to a student, and she fucked up. I'm sorry to say that like that, but I still have some contact with these people, and they were so lovely. I went even to very strict people. I could treat their wives, and always very nice. Because in Antwerp they have many Jewish people in the diamond sector. So
I also had very good experience there. I was there, needed something, and I had very positive experience, as it happens, from this community as well.
We
have a couple questions for you. Okay. Someone already says, sign me up for this course that we'll do. Me too. One person is asking, do you put your hands on the patient's body? And how do you know where to work? And okay, my question, I'll let you do that. And my question is, can I imagine myself really, or do you live without expectation?
Well, I mean, not expecting anything, it's Kishi compared it to a young boy playing a game. The only thing he's expecting is to make progress, but not anything specific, you know. You have to do it before you can understand it, because it comes from the heart. A special topic in Seiki is also Ishin Denshin. It's from heart to heart. So we do not judge, and not to judge a person, we do not diagnose and we do not expect anything. Once again, as Micho Kushi said, it's coming, we have faith in the order of the universe. Like we do not send ki. Ki, she says, if you touch somebody in this spirit, and you might call it Zen-like spirit, if you touch somebody, ki comes. It comes by itself. It comes automatically. The universe is sending the ki. I'm not sending the ki. The universe is sending the ki. I'm just a catalyst. And of course, we touch people in a gentle way, but sometimes we release. We treat from a distance. And what is telling me? I don't know, my subconsciousness, my intuition, my instinct, I don't know. At the same time, for many people, this is very difficult to start with. That's why I worked with Kishi Sensei for 20 years. And I made many notes. That's what I wrote in my book, the notes of which I, and some stories, of course, that I experienced with him. But anyway, there are certain points, certain areas, which I call standard areas, standard points. Sometimes it's acupuncture points, sometimes it's just areas. And the interesting thing is that you touch in that area, but not exactly. So you have to develop your feeling. For instance, I could say you touch the knees, the kneecaps. You touch the kneecaps, both hands, you touch, and you wait. And sometimes you start feeling vibrations or heat, or the person starts to move. But because the touch is always soft, there's no side effect. The touch is gentle, so even if you have a wrong point or not, maybe you're a little bit less efficient or effective, but still there's some reaction. And the more you develop this sensitivity, where to touch, where does the person ask me to touch, you could say. You develop this feeling, I want to touch there. And then they say, how do you know? I just have tensions there. I had a young lady once, and she came for the first time. She doesn't know anything about shiatsu or anything about seiki. And she asked, she had a treatment, and after the treatment, she said, that was really strange. Every time I wanted you to touch me there or there, you did. And she was very enthusiastic in the beginning. She made a second appointment, but 2 days later, she called me and she said, I'm not going to come to my appointment. This is really too weird. So sometimes it has, but this is very important also in Seiki. Like we 100%, I almost say 1000%, we respect the autonomy of a person. We never impose anything. To give another example, I was in Hong Kong, I was teaching there. Now they had to stop doing it because of the troubles there. You have plenty of political troubles. But when people are working and practicing during a workshop, sometimes I come along and I kind of assist them a little bit. And I was just holding from a distance my hands next to the head of one of the people laying on the floor. And suddenly she said, stop, it's too strong. So of course I take my hands away, because we do not want to force anything. We invite the energy to start moving. We invite the person to give up his tensions, but we never push. So we do not encourage people verbally. Although I must admit internally, sometimes I say, come on, let's go. It's your moment, you know. Some people are afraid, of course. And I'm sure that one of the reasons that people have are tired at the end of their lives, they try to kind of cover up all their problems they had and their traumas, and they are sitting on a lid on their subconsciousness, you know, holding this lid. But that makes them sick, of course, and makes them tired. But so this they have to kind of at some point to decide to lift the lid and let things go. And once I had a psychiatrist in one of my workshops, and she did all kind of alternative systems like biodynamics and stuff like that. And there they push people to kind of give up. But she said, what I appreciate in Seiki is that nothing is forced. It all happens in a very natural way. So if you force, like it's like squeezing out, I don't know, an ulcer or how you call it, you know, before it's ripe, you know, have to wait until it's ready. And for some people, it takes some more time. For some people, it comes very fast. So did that answer the question?
You know, it's generally when I have speakers on this forum, they come and they have points. I want to talk about A and B and C, and this is why. And your presentation, Franz, is so gentle. Just your essence, your present, your how you are is so soft. It's just a pleasure.
Yeah, that's what we say. We do not teach. I'm not a teacher. I'm just sharing my experience with people. I consider myself on the same level of my students. I learn from them and they learn from me. Only one thing is sure, I get the money. No kidding. But anyway, it's like, for instance, in Reiki, if you compare, Reiki is more structured than you have hierarchy. In Seiki, there is no hierarchy. We are just senior students. In macrobiotics, you had the senior teachers and associate teachers and whatever. I've never been any of these anyway, neither in macrobiotics, but there are only people with more experience. And I must say, frankly, every year we have now a Seiki gathering with seniors and new people. I learn more from new students than I learn from the seniors. So my teacher is my student at the same time. So, and I find that very interesting.
Why is that? Beginner's mind or why?
Yeah, Shoshin, beginner's mind. That's very important in Seiki, beginner's mind. We never consider ourselves, and we are very, and that I must say, all my colleagues, like, I think we are about 10 people, 10 senior students from Kishi who teach or who share. And they all are very careful, not even, I introduced the term senior students. And even there, people are careful. Well, you have to be careful not to make hierarchy. So there's no hierarchy in Seiki, not at all. Just people with more experience. That's all. Also, I mean, at some point, you know about Shinto. Shinto is Japanese religion. So Kishi introduced us every year, every 2 years. He had a Japan workshop. And then we went to Omoto. That's a Shinto temple. You know Omoto? It's a Shinto temple. This is a book about Omoto. And the funny thing is, I did not know, but you know Aikido? You heard about Aikido? Aikido, this is Japanese martial art. And the founder of Aikido, Ueshiba Sensei, he was a member of Omoto. So for me, everything got together with Kishi. And we went there, and the difference is that for instance, in Reiki, somebody has to open, a master has to open your channels. In Seiki, you have to open your own channels. So autonomy is important, as it is in macrobiotics. Macrobiotics, nobody can do it for you. You have to do it yourself. Same in Seiki. You open your own channels. You open yourself up to the energy of the universe. Nobody else, no priests, no masters, open your channels. And I must say, we had also what they call misogi. And misogi is some kind of a baptism in Shinto. But it's not the priest baptizing you, you baptize yourself. So you have to do some exercise, and then you go stand in a lake, and with the bucket, you baptize yourself. So and for me, this is also the macabre spirit. Like, one of the first books I bought about macrobiotics is Healing Ourselves. You know this book? Healing Ourselves, from Muramoto.
Exactly, yeah, that's right.
And he was a Japanese man who lived in San Francisco. And that was healing ourselves. We have to do it ourselves. And that's the whole point in macrobiotics. You can get inspired, you can get informed, you can get taught, but you have to do it. You have to decide to do it yourself. And it's the same in Seiki. Same in Seiki. Same principle for me. Also, Aikido is the same. For instance, also in Seiki, you have no training. Advanced and beginners, they work together, like in Aikido. And we learn each other, we develop together. So that's a little bit our way. Any more questions?
Anybody? It's interesting that the Jews, when we pray, we also have this motion, this movement, like you spoke
exactly.
about.
Exactly, yeah. exactly. Yeah. Maybe I got it from there, I don't know, but at some point I'm meditating like in Zen, you're sitting still and you cannot move, and many meditation forms. I know many people in all kind of like Indian style meditation and Ayurveda, whatever, and everybody has to sit still. But no, I'm moving a little bit about. And I find this much more calming down, much more in harmony, you know. You have heaven's force coming down from here down, and you have earth force going up, but this force is not going straight, you know. It creates an electromagnetic field like spiral from down and from up also. So this goes to your central channel, and we call that chomai in the Chinese medicine, chomai. So this movement, if this movement through the central channel from your head to your anus is moving faster, then it makes you move. And vice versa, if you start moving, the energy starts moving better. So spontaneously, you get more connection, heaven, earth. So it's all natural. So does anybody have some more questions? I don't know how long I still should talk, but...
No, you're doing great. It's such a nice energy. It's very nice.
Thank you.
Questions, anybody? Here's your chance.
Everybody seems to be satisfied.
Yes, I suppose so.
So maybe somebody else can come forward now. What do you think?
You know, the person or people who tell you that you've done just the right thing, you're also, your timing is perfect. We have 2 minutes left. Mm-hmm. So it's very smooth, gentle presentation. As I've said, I enjoyed it tremendously. And I really thank you very much. Yeah, we're doing just great.
Okay, thank you. Anyway, if you want to contact me, send me an email. I can send you my the way I organize my workshops, and we can maybe fix a date and see what happens. I don't know if with this COVID stuff we already can travel. Maybe it will be for next year, because also this year is quite full already. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so very much, Franz. It was an experience, not just interesting and intellectual. It was really, my heart is so grateful.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye. Bye.